The dust has settled, and E3 2018 has come and passed. Now, this being a Halo-focused channel, pretty much absorbed every little bit of information about Halo Infinite as we can. I do plan to make it my own opinion video that kind of goes more in depth of what I'm thinking, but I kind of wanted to gauge what the community was thinking as a whole. So I got in contact with some other Halo YouTube content creators and asked them for their opinions, and today we've got a special collaboration video for you guys, so I hope you do enjoy it. Before we go into it, I just want to say everyone's link to their channel is in the description down below. Please go give every single one of them a follow. Their content is fabulous, and I just want to say thank you very much to everyone who collaborated with this video. Honestly, I'm surprised that most of you guys even replied back and well, I wanted to participate, so I'm really thankful for everyone's help on this making this video. So without further ado, let's get right into the content.
Hey Kevin, thanks for the request. Happy to talk about Halo's presence at E3. Honestly, we didn't get too much. All we got was the Discover Hope teaser trailer. My thoughts on the trailer, watching it the first time, I was kind of disappointed. I mean, while I was watching the trailer, I was thinking like, where's gameplay? I had my fingers crossed, just hoping we were gonna get some gameplay. When they snapped into POV and the shield recharged and it was like the iconic sound and it was in first person, I was like, holy shit, this is gonna be gameplay. It's gonna snap into like, he's gonna pick up a gun, he's gonna start shooting things, whatever. It didn't happen. It didn't change, like it just changed back out to the cinematic once again, and it cut off and it was another teaser. And just getting a teaser after what a lot of us had expected, a lot of people were just expecting gameplay. It's been about 5 years since we've had an update to the Halo franchise, so we're really just kind of fiending for another Halo title, on top of the fact that there were news outlets that were leaking information saying that there was going to be gameplay. OXM, official Xbox magazine, I'm looking at you, that you guys said that there was going to be, like, there was a leak that we were going to get Halo Infinite gameplay that had like over 4,000 likes or something on Twitter. A lot of people were expecting to see it, so obviously not getting it was disappointing. So I was disappointed at first, and then I kind of sat on it for a bit. I went back, I watched the trailer again. I was like, holy crap, you know, Chief looks amazing. The sounds look amazing. This really does kind of feel like the classic Chief that we know and love. And I went and I read the Associated Waypoint article. I highly recommend anybody who hasn't read that article, go check it out. On the announcement post on Twitter, you can see the link to the Waypoint article. And it just kind of talked about their vision for the game, kind of bringing it back and kind of recapturing the experience, just the general look and feel and atmosphere showcased in the trailer, trying to embody what was so special and unique about that first Halo trilogy, what made it really resonate with so many people, bringing us back to those glory days of the Halo franchise. And I think that's very powerful. That's an amazing statement that they made there, and it made me kind of reconsider my feelings about the trailer and the overall experience of it all. I think it's interesting. It sets a hell of a precedent. It really feels like they're trying to create a love letter for the most hardcore of Halo fans, and it invites a lot of fans that might have previously given up on the franchise back into the franchise, which is great, but it sets a hell of a precedent. I mean, it kind of begs this narrative of, just because, you know, the game's being set back to this classic look and the sounds that we've seen in the original trilogy, what does that mean about the gameplay? Does that mean the gameplay is going to follow suit? And I feel like a lot of classic fans who now have their hopes up for this next title, I feel like they're starting to have those expectations that the classic gameplay is going to follow. And I've seen hashtag no sprint popping up on Twitter everywhere. So it is kind of creating an interesting just precedent going forward. I'm curious to see how they follow up with things. I think they've nailed the look. I think they've nailed the sounds. And while it was a very safe presentation for E3, it does make a powerful statement and it gets people excited. And I think that's very important. So overall, I think they showcased enough to keep us satiated, to keep us going, but I want to see a lot more. And I'm very curious to see what direction they take the gameplay, considering the kind of narrative that they've set up now that they've showcased that they're really trying to please that hardcore, that fan base from the original trilogy. So I'm not sure where it's going to go, man. I'm pretty open-minded about it. Overall, after, you know, watching it a second time, reading the article, I'm excited. I'm optimistic about Halo's future. I guess we'll wait and see.
So I really enjoyed Halo's showing at E3. I know a lot of people were disappointed that there wasn't gameplay, but I wasn't really expecting gameplay this early on. We finally got a release date, which is awesome. I thought the Discover Hope trailer was incredible. The art style, the music, the atmosphere, everything about it was awesome, and it makes me really excited for the future of Halo. So going forward, I believe all we know is the holiday 2020 release. So hopefully there's a beta or something, but I'm super excited for the future of Halo. I think they've won me, and they've won a lot of people over with that trailer from E3. So I'm really excited.
Hey guys, Hidden Xperia here. So what did I think of Halo at E3? Well, I'm going to start off with the positives. I absolutely loved that trailer. That trailer was absolutely gorgeous. The pilot is already, honestly, one of my favorite V43 era characters. I really hope that doesn't jinx his character at all, but like, when I compare him to like Osiris or Majestic or most other V43 introduced characters in Halo 4 and Halo 5, I just prefer the pilot. I think he's such a human character, and that's something that Halo has really needed for quite a while, and I can't wait to see more of him. Chief's armor also looks absolutely gorgeous. Honestly, again, perfect. Exactly what I was hoping for, exactly what I wanted. They could not have made it look any better, apart from the 117 paint on his chest. That's the one thing that I'm not a huge fan of, but yeah, I can deal with that. Honestly, the whole vibe of the trailer was just exactly what I was hoping for. Humanity are properly on the back foot again. I mean, by the looks of it, we actually lost the war against the Created, and I mean, doesn't get any more back foot than that. The classic shield regen sound was just like butter in my ears. It sounded so nice, and the CE-inspired music as well. That still, to this day, after watching the trailer, like, God knows, 30, 40 times, that still sends chills down my spine. It sounds so good. But on the other hand, no gameplay still hurts. Like, I was really, really expecting to see gameplay. Like, even if all those leaks that said that gameplay was coming didn't happen, I still would have been expecting gameplay, and we didn't get any, which really does suck. No dates being revealed for open flighting or a beta is kind of weird as well. I mean, 343 have really committed to a beta for every Halo game moving forward, and if they really want to get some meaningful feedback that they can truly act on from a beta, then it needs to be like a year out from launch. So by that rule, it should be at some point later this year, fingers crossed, but I mean, we've not heard a thing about it yet. I don't know what's going on there. Hopefully we do hear some stuff soon. Overall, what we actually got was almost exactly what I was hoping for. I just wish that we got more of it. Not seeing any gameplay was a real stinger, I'm not gonna lie.
Hey guys, on Kevin's channel, my name is Mintblitz. I'm a Halo montager slash guy who goes for multi-kills from Australia. And he asked me to basically put together what I liked about Halo Infinite, what I disliked, and what are my hopes for the future. So I'm gonna keep it very short, very brief. What I liked was the art style. I'm really happy with how beautiful Halo Infinite is looking. What I didn't like was we didn't see gameplay. Probably isn't ready, so it's not a big deal. And then we also have PC. It's going to hold us over until Halo Infinite launches. So there's lots of stuff as a Halo fan that you can look forward to before Halo Infinite comes out. You also got to keep in mind that Halo Infinite and as well as Halo Reach when it comes out on MCC are both going to have flight tests, so I'm sure Kevin will link it in the URL in the description. If you want to sign up for the flight testing, go and do that so you can test the games before they come out, so you actually get to play it before the release date, which is even better. My hopes for the future is that I want the community to explode, especially when it comes out on PC. I want everyone's channels, I just want the game to be so well populated that you can find a game any time of the day in any specific game mode, and people really enjoy playing again, and there's a really positive atmosphere just in the community, and there's a very good relationship between the players and 343 themselves.
Halo at E3 2019. So it's two things mainly, MCC and Infinite. Obviously, we'll start with Infinite closing out the Microsoft conference. I could not be more excited. From the visual design, the art style, the music, that trailer, the way it built everything together, like, it just has me extraordinarily excited for the future of this franchise. If you read the post over on Halo Waypoint written by Chris Lee, which I recommend everybody does, you get an even better sense of where 343 is going with their next venture in Halo Infinite. I have to admit, I kind of got a lot of those nostalgic feels watching the trailer and getting to see Slipspace really in action for the first time. Obviously, we had the engine demo last year, but this really gave us a practical look of what we can expect or what we can hope to expect with Infinite. Granted, I understand a lot of people are going, man, 2020 is a long time away. And it is for the fan base and the community. Everybody's just always hungry for more Halo, myself included. But I land very firmly in the camp of please take your time and make it the game that it needs to be. I am so strongly in that camp, especially after seeing what's happened with MCC and the radical transformation of that game over time. I want Infinite to have as much time to be built as possible. And I think fans of the series should offer and extend that same kind of thought process as well. Take your time and do it right, and really stoked to see what it's gonna deliver on Scarlet and that whole new arena for Xbox. When it comes to MCC, thrilled that we get basically another year and a half of MCC support as a backbone leading up into Infinite. Halo Reach on PC was getting very positive reports from the players who got the chance to experience it there. Most notably, I think PC Magazine was saying that it feels like a proper PC port, which means a lot because that is something I'm very looking forward to. We know that flighting is coming very soon. So overall, I was pumped with Halo's presence at E3. I think it just is a lot of hype in the scene. If you look at the breakdown of all the trailers that were shown at E3 and the viewer counts, Infinite is way up there. So there's a lot of hype, not just within the Halo scene, but from the broader gamer base as well.
What's going on? My name's Fletch. I co-own a channel called Ultimate Halo. The Halo Infinite trailer was really special to me for numerous reasons, partially because of the callback to Master Chief's original armor, but as well as that, I was really happy with some of the aesthetic choices that were taken. On my channel, I always talk about how the original Halos were late 90s, early 2000s depiction of how the future is going to look. Then the franchise started going down more of a route of this is what we now think the future is going to look like, which I wasn't too much of a fan of, and I think Halo lost a bit of its charm in doing that. Now I'm really happy that they went back to the old school style, and I think everything sort of has a bit more of a rustic, more of a primitive, straightforward, and you almost in a way has more utility or simplistic utility, so to speak. As well as that, I love the music. I love how it actually started to give a really humanized story to this guy. We don't really know his name yet. We're getting to know a lot about from the things I'm hearing. And if there's anything I'm probably not too sure about, it's most likely the idea that it was quite a narrow little segment of the game. We didn't see much gameplay, and I understand that. I think a lot is still yet to change. This game has come out in holiday 2020. I'm still optimistic, and I know quite a few of the guys behind the game, and I can tell you they are just as excited as we are, honestly, and they want to make the best Halo game possible. So who knows? We'll find out. Holiday 2020.
What's up, everybody? This is the Act Man here, and thank you, Kevin Cool X, for having me on your channel to talk about Halo after E3. Alright, so let's run through this. What did I like? The trailer itself, the atmosphere, the fucking music. The armor, the ambiance, cinematography, the emotion behind the trailer is what really captivated me and makes me hopeful for the direction of the story moving forward. It's such a huge contrast between the trailers of Infinite and Halo 5, and I love how they made this trailer feel more grounded and realistic with the pilot, Echo 216, aka Brohammer. He brings some energy and realism to the trailer. Now, what did I dislike? No fucking gameplay. Gave me such blue balls, man. Are you serious? Not even more tech demos of the Slipspace engine? I mean, God. Like, how often does a company come out with a trailer at E3, waits a year, and then just comes out with one more trailer? Like, good lord. Thoughts and predictions I had prior to this were pretty much all off. I'm actually surprised about how wrong I was with all my predictions. But that being said, I am more than willing to wait this out, give it another year, and see what 343 and Microsoft can pull together with the Xbox Scarlet and the technology of the Slipspace engine. I am really looking forward to it.
As someone who was incredibly soured by Halo 5, the Discover Hope cutscene that we saw this year at E3 was everything I was hoping it would be. It hit me like a train with an overwhelming wave of nostalgia and familiarity. This was the Halo that I remember. The tone, the look, the dialogue, the feeling of adventure and excitement, it was all on point. It was even more entertaining to see the reactions all across social media to a Halo that looked immediately more familiar to most gamers. I'm really disappointed that we didn't get to see any actual gameplay or even engine demonstration, but I guess it does make sense seeing as this is the year of Gears of War 5 and Microsoft doesn't want to overshadow their next big release with the more anticipated, I'd say, Halo Infinite, but sadly that's the way things go. I am really interested to see more though. I hope that the gameplay is on point. That's right now my biggest reservation, but as of the tone and the story so far, I'm completely on board.
So it seems like general consensus that people enjoyed the trailer itself, kind of helped show a new direction that 343 is looking to put Halo into, which I think we're all very happy about. Most of us are let down that there was no gameplay, though typically we only ever really see gameplay the year of the release of a game, so I totally understand that. And I think also just the position of where Microsoft decided to show Halo Infinite at the end kind of held it back from giving like a good explanation of what they wanted to accomplish with the game. And I think also that they want to tie it with Xbox Scarlet, that I think if they're going to show gameplay of Halo Infinite, they want to show it on the Scarlet itself. No smoke and mirrors, the real deal kind of thing. So a bit of things Microsoft holding back Infinite from being a full-blown, like, awesome, mind-blowing experience that we saw at E3. Though, it seems like most people are pretty happy about this. We're all very excited, generally, about the direction Halo is going. We cannot wait for Halo Infinite to come out. And I think just that most people were kind of let down from the presentation of the game rather than the game itself and what was shown. And so the future is looking bright, people. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to tap that like button. Let's be known if you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what your thoughts are on the video. And if you're new to the channel and want to update with anything Halo related, make sure to tap subscribe. Make sure to check the description down below for everyone's channel. Subscribe to them as well. Their content's fabulous. You're definitely not going to regret hitting that subscribe button. Again, thank you to everyone who collaborated in this video. I really do appreciate you all taking the time to help out and make something kind of special on the channel, so I really do appreciate you guys a lot. Thank you very much. And just if you guys are new to the channel or miss any content from me, check out the videos on the screen right now. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace out.